So, welcome, welcome, thank you. Today we will be talking about Sun Simiao. Now, Sun Simiao is often called the King of Medicine. Sun Simiao is born in the year 581 AD. And not long after his birth, he becomes an elite scholar and teacher of the art of Chinese medicine and healing, an alchemist devoted to the practice of personal cultivation and longevity, and an author to one of the earliest Chinese encyclopedias for clinical practice. So in this journey, we will be discussing Sun Simiao's life and his thoughts and how he has contributed to the development of Chinese medicine, and how this impacts on present-day practice of Chinese medicine. So Sun Simiao was an avid researcher and an intuitive ponderer of literature, of religions, philosophies, cosmology, and all types of medical texts. His knowledge was very much sought after by the leaders of this time. And he eventually served as a court advisor to the Tang Emperor and for 56 years. Though he was not a practicing physician, his knowledge of Chinese medicine was great. He was a firm believer in the philosophy of nurturing life. And he would personally practice and teach the way of the Tao. Sun Simiao's studies in all areas allowed him to understand that everything is a microcosmic aspect of the macrocosm, and everything has its cycles. He was able to feel and so also teach to his students that the human being and everything on the planet was a microcosm and a macrocosm of something bigger and something smaller than itself. And so the cycles and flows of the five elements and the yin and the yang energies are both within and without the human being and everything on the planet. And thus, these cycles do affect the body. Sun Simiao taught that it was vital for all people to be able to tune into these natural cycles of nature so that they could live in harmony with them. And Sun Simiao quotes that treating disease before it arises, and that the prevention of disease is more important than curing one, as well as firstly, modify the patient's diet and lifestyle, and only then, if they do not affect a cure, treat with medicine and acupuncture. And so when a practitioner is in tune with the flows of nature themselves, it is obvious to see when someone else is not. And when the body is not in balance with itself, it simply cannot be in balance with nature or the cycles. Thus, disease, is only an eventuality. So before a disease can manifest, a good practitioner is able to help that person create balance, be that through acupuncture and energy balancing or dietary and lifestyle advice. Sun Simiao's famous text, which is the first one he created, Essential Formulas for Emergencies Worth 1,000 Pieces of Gold, contains life-saving herbal formulas. And he named it this because he believed that one person's life was more important than 1,000 pieces of gold. And there is a mystical origin attributed to some of the formulas within this book. And so the story tells that Sun Simiao once saved the dragon of the Kunming River, sorry, the dragon of the Kunming Lake in Yunnan province, and as a reward, got 30 magical recipes from the Dragon Palace. The famous encyclopedia text is the first book to give detailed information regarding gynecology, and to separate women's body and mind as medical speciality. So this section was at the very start of his book, and other texts at that time or before only briefly touched about gynecology or women's needs, and at the end of the book, like it was a passing thought. So Sun Simiao went in depth with this topic. The text says that women are 10 times more difficult to treat than men because of the reproductive process and potential uterine problems. And so it's believed that this important text that extensively discusses women's individual requirements thereby set forth the emergence of gynecology as a legitimate field of study and of research, of publication, a respected medical specialty. And in the times, soon after Sun Simiao's life, became a government-funded system of medical training, which has carried through the ages and still holds strong in modern day, especially research and study and publication, etc. So within the first article of the first chapter of this book contains moral standards for the practitioner. And this is China's first code of medical ethics, though it is just more of a reminder and less of a formal code. In this section of the text, Sun Simiao states his beliefs of what a virtuous practitioner ought to do and what he ought to refrain from doing, being very similar to that of the Hippocratic Oath. An example of a quote in this section is, "Do not ponder over the patient's own fortune or misfortune, and thus preserve life and have compassion for it." And they say that Sun Simiao was a fair and compassionate man, and that he believed all physicians of Chinese medicine also ought to be kind and compassionate. This part of Sun Simiao's text provides the future generations of Chinese medicine practice a professional standard to live by and a moral code to live by to treat. And also within this section of the text, Sun Simiao discusses ways of practice to cultivate personal longevity through nurturing life, living in moderation, regularity in diet and lifestyle, avoiding physical overexertion and emotional excess, living in harmony with the seasons. He explains how doing too little of something or too much of something often negatively affects areas of the body, and explains how this process occurs. So it's a lot about moderation and balance, to live in harmony, to not too much yang, not too much yin, not enough yin, not enough yang, keeping balance through all lifestyles, through all practices, through all diets. So Ashi points. Sun Simiao was the first to use the term Ashi point to describe a painful area of the body, which when pressed in this painful area with the finger or something, equipment, would create more pain. The area which is pressed is not the location of a regular acupuncture point, but when needled in this area would create almost instant relief from pain around this painful area. And so the site of an Ashi point is determined by a feeling of dull pain, soreness, pressure, heaviness, or numbness, or change in skin color after being pressed. They have no specific names nor locations, but can be treated either with acupuncture or moxibustion. It's quite interesting for a Western speaker that the word ashi in Chinese means, ah, yes. As in, ah, yes, that's the spot that hurts. So needle that, that's ashi point. So the ashi points are widely used still to this day because they are very effective at relieving pain, especially knotted up muscles and stagnant areas within the body. Even chiropractors and physiotherapists have begun to use this method, but they call it dry needling. But unfortunately, sometimes they say that they are doing acupuncture, but it's not acupuncture because they do not have the technique and the skill and the knowledge nor the practice of a real acupuncturist. So the gross points. Sun Simiao developed a set of points called the 13 ghost points for the purpose of treating mental disorders such as schizophrenia, manic behavior, addictions, and neurological disorders such as epilepsy and paralysis. And also can treat addictions, headaches, depression, anxiety, traumas, all sorts of different things. In the ages before and after Sun Simiao's life, it was often believed that these types of disorders were caused by invading spirits and ghost possessions. So imagine someone in those days having a seizure, drop on the floor, convulsing, and yeah, so they would believe that this is a ghost possession. But according to Sun Simiao, these apparent ghosts affecting the mind is actually excess phlegm misting the heart mind, so the shin. Excess phlegm can be the result of long-standing emotional issues or trauma, weak essence, weak jing, poor diet, external pathogens invading the body, drugs, or even shock. So all of the ghost points have applications that affect patients' emotional and physiological welfare. And when used together, they can create a sense of peace and help to center and ground the patient. And so an example of one of these points, what they do is, so pericardium 8. So this is a good point for a patient who has lost a sense of self, are manic with hallucinations, anxious, and experiencing paranoia. So this is very much like schizophrenia. So that's all that we'll be discussing about Simiao's life. And so overall, Sun Simiao has had a strong influence on acupuncture and Chinese medicine through the ages and through this day now in this modern era, and through his writings on ethics, gynecology, prevention of disease, the ashi points, the ghost points, and there's much, much more. So thank you, Sun Simiao, for your knowledge and everything. And thank you, audience, for listening and being such humble listeners. That is all. Thank you.